فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد بن عبد الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. My beloved brothers and sisters, today inshallah ta'ala I want to speak about a topic that I find very important, especially at this time in which we're living. This topic is not specific to the youngsters only, but it also encompasses the elders. And this is a قَضِيَّ مِمَّا عَمَّتْ بِهِ الْبَلْوَى. The problems regarding it is too much, vast. Wherever you go, you will struggle to be in an environment where you don't come into contact with this. And this is music. And what does our religion believe regarding it? If you take a taxi, it's on. If you go to a shop, it's on. If you even come to the masjid, the person next to you or behind you or even in front of you, his ringtone is a music. And this is a problem. What does the Quran believe regarding it? And what does the sunnah? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the Quran, وَاسْتَفْزِزْ مَنِ اسْتَطَعْتَ مِنْهُمْ بِصَوْتِكَ وَأَجْلِبْ عَلَيْهِمْ بِخَيْلِكَ وَرَجْلِكَ وَشَارِكْهُمْ فِي الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَوْلَادِ وَعِدْهُمْ وَمَا يَعِدُهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ إِلَّا غُرُورًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he tells us in this verse, he says, وَاسْتَفْزِزْ مَنِ اسْتَطَعْتَ مِنْهُمْ بِصَوْتِكَ. Shaytan, incite to senselessness whoever you can from amongst those individuals, those people. Shaytan, use your voice senselessly. Destroy them with your voice. مَنْ اسْتَطَعْتَ مِنْهُمْ. From whoever amongst them you're able to do. And not only at that point, Shaytan, don't stop to that point. Use your horsemen and your foot patrol. Make an army and use it against them. وَشَارِكُمْ فِي الْأَمْوَالِ. And be in partner with them in their wealth. وَالْأَوْلَادِ. And their children. وَعِدْهُمْ. And give them false promises. وَمَا يَعِدْهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ إِلَّا غُرُورًا. And Shaytan does not promise except towards delusion. This ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking in the context of when Shaytan was taken out of paradise. And he was kicked out of paradise after he clearly disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to him here, use your voice. The Mufassirin, such as Mujahid ibn Jabrin, Ibn Jarir al-Tabari brings in his tafsir, and Ibn Kathir also, that Mujahid said that the voice of Shaytan that is meant in this verse, that he uses senselessly and that he misguides the people with, Mujahid, who Sufyan al-Thawri said, إِذَا جَاءَكَ تَفْسِيرُ مُجَاهِدٍ. If the tafsir of Mujahid comes to you, فَحَسْبُكَ بِهِ. Enough, don't look for more. If he comments on a verse, it's enough for you. You don't need to look for anybody else's commentary on the verse and anyone else's exegesis on the Quran. He's sufficient for you. This individual Mujahid said regarding this verse, بِصَوْتِكَ, your voice, he said, هُوَ الْغِنَى, it is music. Mujahid said it's music. So Shaytan uses his voice to incite senselessness, misguidance towards whoever he wishes. And we have been duped and fooled to believe that through music, good is going to come to us. And that music is permissible. when shaitan is taking every single path, ya ikhwa, to misguide you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in that particular verse as well, He says subhanahu wa ta'ala that shaitan has an army. His army consists of horsemen and those who are foot patrol. They walk on their feet. These individuals are those who push this music forward. They are the rappers. They are the artists who are singing. And those Muslims who are also listening to it have a portion in this verse as well. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He reminds us in that particular verse as well, وَشَارِكْهُمْ فِي الْأَمْوَالِ Shaytan has partnership with you in your wealth. You go and you buy music. You plug an internet into your house and you allow your children to listen to the music. You buy them a mobile phone and you don't observe what they're doing. And Shaytan has partnership with you in your own children. Last week, or a couple of weeks ago, I spoke about the concept of what does the Sharia believe regarding blood and the severity of it. But then I had discussion with many youths, many youngsters, and they told me that they never knew the severity of blood, because the way that rappers and artists propagate killing is easy, senselessness. Even the games that youngsters play with, Black Ops, they play, they are taught to kill. So when a child takes a knife, he stabs somebody or he kills somebody, it's because of the lyrics and the music that he's listening. It's the movies that he's watching that are propagating this like it's nothing. The ma'asi and the sins have become nothing to him. Senselessness. He doesn't feel it. And all of this is through the voice of shaitan. Parents, you need to know what your children are listening to and what they're watching. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He tells us in another ayah, He says, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ from amongst the people are those مَنْ يَشْتَرِي لَهْوَ الْحَدِيثِ those who buy the amusement of speech. What does it mean? لَهْوَ الْحَدِيثِ amusement of speech. Again, Abdullah ibn Abbas, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, Jabir ibn Abdullah, Ikrima, Sa'id ibn Jubayr, Mujahid ibn Jabrin, Makhul, Amr ibn Shu'ayb, Hassan al-Basri, all of them, they said it's music. These are the a'immah of tafsir, the scholars of tafsir, who when we want to know what the Quran means, we take it to them. All of them, bittifaq. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud took it a step further, and he said, Wallahi alladhi la ilaha ghayruh. I swear by the Lord, in which there is none worthy of worship except Him. And if Ibn Mas'ud was to say it is music, and he didn't swear by Allah, we would have taken it from him. He's a noble companion. Then what would the situation be if Ibn Mas'ud swore by Allah? The matter becomes great, brothers, wallahi. He says, Wallahi alladhi la ilaha ghayru. I swear by the Lord, in which there is none worthy of worship except Him, except that this verse is talking about music. A day ago, I went to a barber's to cut my hair. And when I went in, music was on. I requested from the man if he can switch off the music because I'm the only person who's here. He was a Muslim. I asked him, switch it off. He said, who said music is haram? Where did you get this concept from? Ya ikhwa ibn Mas'ud and Mujahid and Sa'id ibn Jubayr and Tawus and Ikrimah and Amr ibn Shu'ayb and Hassan al-Basri. All of them are talking about music better than the music that our youngsters are listening today. The lyrics and the words and the videos that they're watching, the things that they're seeing, is far greater today than it was at a time of Hassan al-Basri and Amr ibn Shu'ayb and Tawus and other than them. Matters have gone worse and it's getting worse. Our children, wallahi, because of music, they have become animals. And this is a reality. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to us, in a hadith, al-Imam al-Bazzar and Daya al-Maqdisi rahimahullah, and you can find it in the book, al-Targhib wa al-Tarhib by Imam al-Mundhiri rahimahullah, and Sheikh Nasir rahimahullah, rahmatan wasi'ah, he authenticated this in this hadith, in this book of his. And he graded it to be a hadith which is Hassan, that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, Sawtani mal'unani, two types of verse, two types of voices are cursed. Sawtani mal'unani, two types of voices are cursed. What does al-la'nu mean, ya ikhwa? Al-la'nu means at-tardu min rahmatillah. Allah's mercy is distant from you. If the Prophet cursed those people, we will curse it as well. Sawtani, two types of voices. Mal'unani, they are cursed. Fi dunya, they are cursed in this world. Wal akhirati, and they are cursed in the hereafter. Mizmarun, the music that is listened to. Inda ni'ma, when the person is enjoying himself. When he's having fun, the music which he puts on, that person, on the tongue of the messenger, he has told us that that individual, the music and the person who sing it are both cursed. The second type is waranatan inda al-musiba, and the person's wailing when calamity is before them. Those two types of people are cursed. The messenger alayhi salatu wasalam told us, a people who's cursed, what khair do you await from them? And the one who is listening to it, and I'm going to later bring it, that Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said, لَعَنَ اللَّهُ الْمُغَنِّي وَالْمُغَنَّى لَهُ. May Allah's curse be upon the one who sings and the one who is listening to the song. May Allah's both of them be, the curse of Allah be upon them. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud is saying, a man who wants to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with every statement he says, he has specifically said this. The matter has been taken very lightly. Rather, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud went on to say, he said, إِنَّ الْغِنَى music يُنْبِتُ فِي الْقَلْبِ النِّفَاقِ. It brings in the heart hypocrisy. Wallahi, today when you listen and you look at the youngsters who are listening to music today, who are justifying music and saying it's permissible, and they are listening to it, if you watch them and they come to the masjid, wallahi, they can't even do the ruku' properly. Wallahi, if they read the Quran, they bring out their mobile phones and they keep using it. وَإِذَا قَامُوا إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ قَامُوا كُسَالًا. When they stand up in the prayer, they pray lazy. وَلَا يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. And they don't remember Allah except little. Wallahi, some of them, wallahi, وَبِاللَّهِ وَتَاللَّهِ, some of these youngsters, when you look at them, you will question yourself, are they even in a civilized world? Their nails are long, so much filth and dirt are in it. They look like animals that have been taken out of. One of these youngsters who listen to music and who are in drugs and everything, I invited him one time and I said, let me buy you food. Wallahi, the way he ate food, I was shocked. Have you not eaten in a long time? This is something that is going on in front of our eyes. When are we going to wake up and see what's happening? When are we going to realize what our youngsters and our youth are going through and the children are being done to? The messenger told us, alayhi salatu wasalam, in a hadith, Abi Malik al-Ash'ari radiallahu ta'ala anhu narrated that the Prophet said, and the hadith is found in Sahih al-Bukhari, that the Prophet said, لَا يَكُونَنَّ مِنْ أُمَّتِ أَقْوَامِ. In my ummah, there are going to be people. يَسْتَحِلُّونَ الْحِرَى وَالْحَرِيرَى. They are going to make permissible for themselves illegal sexual intercourse. They are going to say, zina is halal. We're going to live at a time when we're going to see with our two eyes and hear with our ears a people who will say, committing zina, there's no problem. It's your choice. Do you want it? Do it. We will also see men who are wearing silk, and silk is haram for the men. Then the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, wal khamra, and they will make permissible for themselves the drinking of khamr. Wal ma'azif, and they will make permissible for themselves music. They will say music is halal. There's nothing wrong. It's permissible. Allah has allowed it. The Messenger has allowed it. It is something a person can do. Isn't that a waqi' that we're living on? Or living in and seeing? Then the Prophet went on to saying, وَلَيَنْزِلَنَّ أَقْوَامٌ إِلَىٰ جَنْبِ عَلَمٍ. A group of people are going to be residing in a side of a mountain. يَرُوحُ عَلَيْهِمْ بِسَارِحَةٍ لَهُمْ. A shepherd would come in need of something from them. يعني الفقير. He would come to them asking them for something. And they would say to the shepherd, إِرْجِعْ. Go back and come to us. إِلَيْنَا غَدًا. Tomorrow we will give you what you're asking for. But in that period of time, they're listening to their music, they're enjoying themselves. So they say, come back to us tomorrow. But they're listening to music. So these shepherds, in need, they leave them. فَيُبَيِّتُهُمُ اللَّهُ. Allah takes the mountain and He places it on their head. He destroys them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيَضَعُ الْعَلَمَ وَيَمْسَخُ الْآخَرِينَ قِرَدَةً وَخَنَازِيرٌ. And the other remaining ones, Allah turns them into monkeys and pigs. إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ, until the day of judgment. Wallahi, today when you look at rappers and artists and singers, the way they move their hands, the way they jump, wallahi, Allah has already turned them into qirad and khanazir in this world. Just watch them, what they do when they're singing and they're rapping, jumping on the car, jumping on the wall, the way he does everything, the noise that they make. Some of them even call themselves dogs. He's a rapper, his name is called Dog. Your youngster, he looks at that child. He looks at an individual because you brought a 52-inch plasma television. You brought a laptop. You brought him a mobile phone and you're not observing his situation. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us that this is going to happen in this ummah. Alayhi salatu wa sallam. He says, in another hadith, he says, la yakunanna fi hadhihi al-ummah. There's going to take place in this ummah. Khasfun wa qadhfun. In this ummah, what's going to happen is earthquake. Allah is going to destroy them and make the earth swallow them. Wa qadhfun, Allah is going to throw rocks at them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa maskhun, Allah is going to deform their image and the way they look. Wa dhalika, and this is going to be. Ida sharibul khumura, when the people start drinking alcohol. Wa takhadul qiyanat, and they take women who are going to sing for them. And they say, sing, YouTube. A man's bringing his wife to YouTube and he says, sing. Opens the channel for her. 100 people are watching her. He says, sing, no problem. She sings. Men and women are listening to her. وَضَرَبُوا بِالْمَعَازِفِ. And then they come and they use musical instrument. When this happens, Allah will bring earthquake. Allah will deform us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's going to bring stones from the sama on us. Are we going to wait for that to happen? Or are we going to stop the sufaha, the dim-witted ones from amongst us who are doing this? Stop it. And make them stop this corruption that they're doing. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam said in another hadith, "La yashrabanna nasun," a group of people will drink alcohol. "Min ummati," from my ummah. "Yusammunaha bighayri ismiha," they will call the alcohol a name other than its name. Ask the youngsters today, what is it that you call drug alcohol? You call it food. They call drugs food. They've given it a name which is good. He will come up to you and he will say to you, do you have food? This is drugs. He's asking you for drugs. يُسَمُّونَهَا, he names it, بِغَيْرِ اسْمِهَا, other than its name. This is a waqa that we're living in. But the powerful thing in this hadith is that the Prophet said in the context of music. Because those who are going to listen to music are going to call it anashid islamiyya. يُسَمُّونَهَا بِغَيْرِ اسْمِهَا. The Prophet then says, يُعْزَفُ عَلَى رُؤُوسِهِمْ, on top of their face, in front of them, people are going to sing for them and they're going to bring women who are going to be musicians for them. Allah is going to deform those individuals and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to change them into وَيَجْعَلُ مِنْهُمُ الْقِرَدَةَ وَالْخَنَازِيرَ. The Prophet cried one day alayhi salatu wasalam, and he cried this when he lost his son Ibrahim. And so when he cried and tears came out of his eyes alayhi salatu wasalam, the sahabas, they said, "Ya Rasulallah, atabki, are you going to cry? And you are the one who prohibited us from crying." Then the Messenger said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this hadith is in Tirmidhi, min hadith Jabir. The Prophet said, "Innama nuhitu anil buka." What I was prohibited is from, the Prophet said, "Innama," he said, "Inni ma nuhitu anil buka." I was not prohibited from crying. No. "Walakinni nuhitu," but I was prohibited. "An sawtaini ahmaqaini fajirataini." Number fajiraini. The Prophet said, I was prohibited from two dim-witted, fajir sounds. The one who sings and the one who's listening to music are ahmaq and they are fajir, based on the hadith of the Prophet. Sawtun inda musiba. That voice that is said when calamity befalls you. The foul language that a person comes with. وَصَوْتٌ, and the sound that comes out of a person. عِنْدَ فَرَحٍ, when he's happy. Another riwayah mentions that the Prophet said, when it is لَهُوٍ وَلَعِبٍ وَمَزَامِيرَ الشَّيَاطِينَ. Music, singing, all of this, the Prophet said, it comes out of the mouth. Because this was in the context of the Prophet crying. Beatboxing and all of that, they fall under that hadith. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said, "Al-ghina music yumbitu an-nifaqa fil qalb." Hypocrisy comes from music, ya ikhwatil kiram. Also Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he said, "La'ana Allah," may Allah's curse be upon, "al-mughanni wal-mughanna lahu," the one who sings and the one who is sung for. Also Fudayl ibn Iyad rahimahullah, he said, Al-ghina ruqyatu zina. That music is the ruqya of zina. You want homosexuality to spread? You want zina to spread? Put on music. Liwat ibn al-Qayyim mentions in his kitab Ighathatul Lahfan, fi masayid al-shaytan. Any place in which music spreads, homosexuality spreads, and zina spreads. وَهَذَا مَعْلُومٌ. That's something that is known. Ibn al-Qayyim says, فَلَعَمْرُ اللَّهِ by Allah, كَمْ مِنْ حُرَّةٍ. How many righteous, free women who was good, صَارَتْ بِالْغِنَى, because of music she became, مِنَ الْبَغَايَا, she came from that, she became a prostitute because of music. How many women? وَاللَّهِ, one of the people that the youngsters are looking at and they are idolizing, they look up to them, they came through into the industry by zina. They became famous because of zina videos that spread. What is this woman going to think? If she wants to be famous, she has to do zina. And then that video has to spread on social media and she will become famous. Famous and your name being known by all means necessary is justified, no problem. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. My beloved brothers and sisters, I want to conclude. There is also another thing that many people justify. They use it as a stepping stone. But in reality, it still takes the ruling of music. And this is what they call anashid Islamiyah, Islamic anashid. ولذلك, this is something that hasn't come recently. This is something the Salaf of this Ummah, Al-Imam al-Shafi'i and others have heard of. ولذلك Al-Imam al-Shafi'i رحمه الله, he said, خلفت ببغداد. I have left behind in Baghdad شيئاً أحدثته الزنادقة. The ones who introduced it, the ones who brought it forward are the heretics. The زنادقة were the ones who inherited this. يسمونه, they call this thing التغبير. This is what they call it, which is what we call Adashi today. يصدون بها الناس. They are diverting the people عن القرآن from the Quran. الإمام أحمد رحمه الله was asked, ما تقول في أهل القصائد? What do you say about those people who listen to قصيدة and these anashid, which they call it today? And Abu Ahmed ibn Hanbal said, بدعة innovation. لا يجالسون. Those people are not sat with. No one should sit with those individuals. And علامه and the following scholars, they graded and they considered anashid to be haram. From them is الشيخ العلامة محمد ناصر الدين الألباني and also الشيخ العلامة محمد بن صالح العثيمين and also الشيخ العلامة عبد العزيز بن عبد الله بن باز and also الشيخ العلامة صالح بن فوزان الفوزان and also الشيخ العلامة حمود بن عبد الله التويجري and also الشيخ العلامة عبد المحسن العباد and last but not least الشيخ صالح الفوزان حفظه الله تعالى. Brothers, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the affairs of your children. And also fear Allah in the wealth that you have gained and the money that you have. What are you spending it in? Wallahi, you will be asked the day of judgment. And also look at what your children are up to and what they're listening to. Don't destroy your own household by bringing instruments that you're not observing. Wallahi, you will be asked the day of judgment. And every single question will be put towards you. Allahumma ighfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina wa thabbit aqdamana wa ansurna ala alqawmi alkafirin. اللهم اغفر لنا هزلنا وجدنا وخطأنا وعمدنا وكل ذلك عندنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم لا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك فينا ولا يرحمنا. رب آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وأقم الصلاة.